Welcome back to Hollywood, the Music Box, the World Series of Boxing. After one fight tonight, the lightweight division, Astana has jumped out to a 1-0 lead. Up next, the middleweights. Jeffrey the Nightmare Camp, a rookie coming in, will tell you his amazing story, taking on the bronze medalist from Beijing, Kanat. Slam. Ready? And we're ready to go. Round one scheduled for 5. And Joe, tall order for this kid. Jeffrey the Nightmare Camp hoping for a Rocky moment tonight because he was going to be in an amateur fight in Cincinnati tonight. He got a call on Thursday, and here he is on television fighting the bronze medalist.
Well, he's in an amateur pro fight tonight, and he's getting paid, so I like this one better. Now he's in there with a definitely much tougher guy. This guy's a world-class amateur slam, so... Camp is in there tough tonight, but he's a southpaw, so he's got a little bit of a built-in advantage here. And he looks like he's pretty smart. He's got good eyes. He's keeping a close eye on Slam here. Let's see what he can do. If he can counter punch.
Slam throwing the big right hand, and he's got the nightmare over there in the corner.
You saw what Camp did, though. He waited to pick off one or two punches, and he came back with a three-punch combo. None of them landed, but that's what he intends to do tonight, is big box counter punch.
One of his teammates in the Matadors, Russell Lamore, they call him the Haitian Sensation. He's not fighting tonight, but he knew this kid and out of Dayton, Ohio, and recommended they pick him up because they had lost a middleweight and they needed one. And here he is, and let's see what he can do. He's being patient. I like that in the first round. Left-hander.
Slam just fine. He got close with the right hand, landed one, and Camp tried to counter, but got hit with two body shots right there on the counter.
Well, got right hand.
There it is.
Got right hand. Jeffrey Camp's in trouble up there, right hand, Joe. That hurt. He's got to get him off the ropes. Coach is telling him get off the ropes there. If he just stands there, he's just going to be cannon fodder.
Yeah, stop. Slam had a corner there, hit him with three right hands to the body that came up at the last punch and clipped him right on the chin. So he worked him over pretty good in the corner there with Slam. But Camp's got to stay out of these corners. He'd be better off in the middle of the ring, circling a little bit, using his jab and his southpaw advantage he's got. And it is a southpaw advantage because it's a near opposite image of what these right-handers normally see every day in the gym. Southpaws are far and few between the two.
Well, he's in against a very accomplished bronze medalist. Slam is from so far west in China, I can't even find it on the map. It's just east of Kazakhstan, south of Mongolia. Here's a guy, a real rags-to-riches story, going to Beijing in his home country of China and winning that bronze. Yeah, look at Camp stepping up. He's got Slam on the ropes.
But he's trying to even up the round right there because, Slam's had the advantage with the amount of punches he's landed so far. And Camp knows he's got to get it back. This is what he's trying to do.
Right. Straight right, though, right there. Over the top, bounce Camp off the rope. You know, I can see Camp in just a couple of minutes gaining a little confidence in there. He's never been in this position before. He's never fought with that headgear.
No, but he looks cool and confident right now. He's getting tagged a little bit. He's in there with a real sharpie. But Camp is looking to win.
Look at that, right at the end there.
I'll tell you what, he did a pretty good job of evening up that round by landing those good shots here on the rope.
There he is in the corner, and like I said, this year, he was a semifinalist in the Police Athletic League tournament back there in Ohio. And somebody recognized he has enough to come in here and at least make it competitive. And like I said, a Rocky story getting a chance against Kanat Slam, a world-class, well-known middleweight. And let's take a look at what he was able to do, Joe.
There's Camp. This is probably towards the end of the round where he came back at him, trying to even it up a little bit. Now those are glancing off the gloves ahead, but he lands one off the top of the head there, right hook. And here it comes. I think this left hand will, well, it gets deflected.
Seconds out, mouthpiece is in.
Barely lands. But he's throwing punches and he's got Slam on the defense. That's better than having Slam take you apart.
Well, it's a very quick learning curve, isn't it, Mr. Goosen, when you learn to not stand in the corners against a world-class middleweight like this. Round two, scheduled for 5, middleweight division. Matadors have lost the lightweight fight tonight, so they'd like to get even here with a true Rocky. Hey, look at it go. He decided, Mr. Captain decided to go to school a little bit. Now he's getting all pumped up. That's fun.
Well, you know, he knows he's behind. He probably lost that first round. He wants to win the second round. So, like I said, Camp came here to win, Alan. And he's trying his best against this bronze medal winner from the Beijing Olympics. So if he can hang in there and win this fight, it's a huge feather in his game.
He just needs to stay out of that corner. He's using a little more head movement now, Joe. Jeffrey Camp from Dayton, Ohio in the red trunks. Kanat Slam from China fighting for Kazakhstan here. Like working on a heavy bag back there to get him in that position.
Well, Camp is posing there in the corner, and he's trying to counter. He's let the slam hit him with one or two body shots off the elbows, and he's trying to come up the middle and counter. It's not working so far.
Break! Stop! Box!
Kanat Slam was ranked in the world with a couple hundred fighters we have in the World Series of Boxing. Ranked number 13. He did lose three fights last year. Fought seven times. It's a grind, this series. Fighting seven times within 4 months. Five round fights. I like the way that Camp's pushing forward here.
He is. But one final thought on what you were saying, how it goes to show you. Here's a kid, Slam, who won a bronze medal at the Beijing Olympics and went 4-3 here in this competition against these amateurs. Shows you the quality of the amateurs that they've got. The WSB.
Good right hand from Slam right there. I think that one got through. Now he's just trying to tee off.
Now if he doesn't punch back, they will stop this fight.
Camp took all that and threw a wild right. You can't stand there and let Slam just start throwing punches on you. You gotta do some movement because he won't stop.
The referee Zach Young is keeping a closer eye right now because now Camp's starting to miss wildly.
Seconds.
Yeah, he's just trying to cover up in the corner now. It's a very defensive position, and he's starting to get hit a lot.
His legs are wobbly right now. Can't try to clear up a little bit, get back in the center of the ring. Crowd getting quite excited about this. 20 seconds left, round number two. We're in the middleweights.
Well, you see here, Slam is the one to throw all the punches, but Camp still not punching back here. So Slam looks like he's in better condition. He's ready to do more here, and he has.
Time!
Okay, there's the corner of the bronze medalist who that round really took charge by just trying to just clean up when he had an opportunity, Joe. Let's take a look at some of Slam's work.
There's that right hand of the body. See, he's got his elbows up way too high. You got to have him tighter and down lower. And he's getting hit with that same right hand of the body all night. Here's the combination of about 20 punches that Slam's doing. Now, they're all kind of haymakers left and right. But you know what? There's some of it's getting through. Some of it's hitting. So there's the one that got him that was all that left up. Otherwise, they're not the most effective punches, but they sure don't look good, and they sure don't feel good. And it'll give the referee an opportunity to stop the fight if you don't punch back in the situation. Better to be careful next round of doing that.
Let's go to round number three here in Hollywood. Jeffrey Camp in the red trunks, gold trim, taking on the bronze medalist from Beijing, Kanat Slam in the gold trunks, black trim. Tough second round for Jeffrey Camp, who only had a couple of days notice to be here, so he was preparing for an amateur fight in Ohio. I don't think in his wildest dreams he's prepared to go to Hollywood and fight without headgear as professional. But the good thing is, things don't go well, he can go back to Cincinnati and retain his amateur status. He's got nothing to lose, really.
You do not. This is the beauty of this. And he's only got 25 fights total in his group. Compared to most of these guys on this card, he's really a true novice. But he's got a lot of style. I like the way Camp looks. He just, this other kid, Slam, is just a little bit too much for him.
Too seasoned, perhaps, on the world stage.
But Camp, he's trying to make it competitive, and he is at times. But now here you've got Slam going southpaw, giving Camp a little taste of his own medicine. It goes to show you how versatile Slam is by
going the other way in a southpaw style, or he's that confident. One or the other. There's a nice left over the top for Camp. He's hit better defense, that's for sure, here in the third round. Being force-fed in education, that's for sure, tonight here in the third round in Hollywood.
Slam almost looks like he's having a little fun here, switching back and forth. You know, I think sometimes that'll get you into trouble.
I've seen it before. Get a little overconfident, get clocked with something.
Brown Camp's still trying to land something big here. He's looking for it. He's not giving up.
Round number three scheduled for five. All our fights here at WSB World Series of Boxing scheduled for five rounders. No headgear, 10-9 mess system, professional judges and referees.
It's a nice jab by Camp right there. If you can follow that up with a short left hand over the top, he might get somewhere. He's just not doing enough with his hands. He's got to let his hands go a little bit. Especially since Slam's throwing so many punches, he might be a little tuckered out right now. So go ahead and try it. One of the big advantages southpaws have is their strong hand is right in front of the right part of your rib cage where your liver sits. And let me just tell you something. If Camp started going like he just did right there, he tried for it. It's a great shot for a southpaw user. He hasn't used it tonight. Here we go again, though. Sitting on the ropes.
Way too much time on the ropes. Slam's got a grin on his face about the way things are going. Kind of showboating a little bit here, as much as these guys do from the Astana team. They're usually all business, but you can't help but he's trying to enjoy himself a little bit in here.
Yeah, he's got his mouth open a little bit too here. Yeah. It's been a great time for call.
Final seconds, round number three, middleweight division. Joe Goosen enjoying the fights tonight. It's a product I hope people will come to really enjoy. I was thinking about Astana too. One of the factors you think about, they've traveled a long way. They didn't get here but just a couple of days ago. The time clock could weigh on them a little bit.
Well, thank goodness they're all in their 20s or younger. Because if it was you or I, Al, we'd need about a week to recover time. You're right. I mean, it's a long trip and it's a hard trip, but I think the adrenaline takes over and it doesn't matter where you are. They're just in a ring. Slam is looking good, isn't he?
Yeah, he certainly is. But Jeffrey Camp, I can give him a lot of credit. He's now in round number four, a kid who had no possibility of knowing on Wednesday that he would be here. And he took the challenge, knowing what he was up against. And like we pointed out, he really has nothing to lose. He's going to learn a lot tonight. He can go back to Dayton, Ohio, put the headgear back on, develop as an amateur. But why not give it a shot? He's making a little bit of money here tonight. And well, see what you got.
Making a little money, and he landed a little leather. He had a nice little dip left hand come over the top and landed it on Slam. But as usual, Slam will get it back 10-1, which he's doing right now.
Yeah, he's working downstairs, upstairs, split the gloves there with the left hand. And you notice the pattern to the first two Astana fighters. Just pressure fighters, you know, they're not going to go out there and dance like Sugar Ray Leonard or anything like that. They're just going to come right at you, but they're very skilled. You can see Joe's paid him a compliment for the first two. They look like professionals that could do some damage out in the real world.
In all fairness, even a guy like Camp looks to me like he has a much more pro style than he does an amateur style. You know, he's trying to counter, he's trying to set up his punches, but against a guy this busy, you're going to have to be more than that.
Coming up on 1 minute left in round number four, and Jeffrey Camp is still there.
Looks like a little of the steam has come off the punches of Slam. They don't look as crisp and as hard as the first few rounds, but he just didn't land it a nice, from a southpaw position, landed a good one too on Camp.
He likes to finish up if he can in here when he gets into the corner.
We're going to stop the fight here, watch.
Yeah, there you go.
That was enough.
Zach Young had seen enough of that to know that Richard Camp came, he didn't conquer, but you know, got to give the young man effort for taking the challenge, and A for effort. But Zach wasn't going to let, Jack Young wasn't going to let that continue. He said it too much.
What showed through really was the experience, the confidence, the composure of Slam.
Let's take a look at some of what Slam was doing here. We saw a lot of it, but Joe, you talked about the accurate punches.
There it was. That was the 1-2 I called at the end. He did that for himself opposition. Now he backs him up into the corner, lands that path of right hand, bam, that left hook too, and he just starts letting him go. Short, mostly right hands, little touches with the left hook there. That left uppercut was the last one that landed, and Zach Young wisely stepped in and stopped him because it wasn't going anywhere.
The bronze medalist gets off to his 2011 WSB series on a victorious note.
And of all the guys that we have in this, this fight card tonight, Al, Jeff Camp was that was probably the least experienced guy on either team with 25 fights.
But he'll learn a lot from this. Now at least you know what's out there.
Well,
from way across the globe, you know what kind of fighters out there if you're going to become a world-class professional.
This is why I love the idea of this league, this team. You're gonna see people you would normally never see, except maybe on the Olympics, because they're, you know, it's either pros or it's the Olympics. That's what you see. You see very few amateur fights on television.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is
Mike Vail with the official decision. Official announcement.
Number four, referee Zach Young stops this bout for your winner by knockout, Kanat Slam.
Seeing him down the road, I'm sure. You know, he's 27 too, Joe. That's if he's going to take that next step, it might be soon. He probably was going to try to go back to another Olympics in London and then see what goes on from there. But there's certainly a fertile ground for people that are looking for talent in the country of Kazakhstan. We'll be right back to Hollywood with more action in the World Series of Boxing here on Fox Sports.